Hi guys, it's Alston. In this video, we are going to learn about Tomba email finder and verifier tool. It's almost like an alternative to hunter.io, where it helps you to find email addresses from website domain name list or web pages list, or help you to find email addresses by suggesting names and company. It will try to come up with a potential email addresses, and it will also help you to verify email addresses based on all the variety of checks to making sure that whatever the email you have discovered is actually valid and deliverable for whatever the outreach purposes. The first thing I wanted to address is that their website is poor in design, to be honest, where it does not give so much confidence when we are looking onto an email finder. I hope that they will do a much better designing job of their website, because their tool is actually really great and does a really good job of it. So in this video, I'm going to showcase the tool, and they have a great deal going around. I have linked on the video description. You can check out if you are interested after seeing this video. Okay, let me go into the app itself. Basically, this is the Tomba web application where it can use it to find email addresses, verify all those sort of stuff. But you are not just restricted to do all this works directly from within the app, where most of you won't even log into their website, because they have all the other ways of using Tomba. For example, if you are using a Chrome web browser or Chromium web browser, you can use their Chrome extension. Or if it's a Firefox web browser, you can use their Firefox add-on. Or if it's a Microsoft, you want to use Microsoft Excel add-on. And if it's a Thunderbird solution, they have a separate Thunderbird solution app for that. And finally, a Safari web browser extension as well. So most of you won't even need to log in into the app. You can use this services from one of these web extension application itself. So let me go through some of the features which is available within Tomba to give you a better understanding on what it does and what kind of features does it provide. Basically, it is divided into five major components inside it. The first one is called domain search, where basically we provide a domain name, or if you are on an extension, you visit to any website and click on domain search, and it will show all the email addresses it was able to find within that particular domain name. For example, as you start typing something, it automatically try to pop up different suggestions based on their database and everything. If you see something, you can just directly click on it. But if you don't see anything, you can go ahead and type. And you can see, once I type, it automatically identify the name of the company, gives me a logo in case if they have it, and the domain name, and it shows out how many email does it was able to find out. So when I click on it, now what it will do is it will select that, and when I click on search, by clicking on all, it will try to bring up all the emails it was able to find. Either can be personal or generic, where generic emails like stands like support at something, or generic admin at something, where the names are generic. Personal is where some kind of a first name or a personal name is used within the email addresses. So depending on your need, you can filter out whichever the one you want. And you can see it shows all the email it found. For example, it shows the common pattern for this kind of email, this particular domain name, and how they are creating email addresses. The reason is, in case if you are unable to find an email address, you can pretty much try to guess the email addresses from something like this. So it shows what kind of the common pattern. You can also select and filter it out by department. Obviously, this is not going to be available for every single domain addresses. Depending on how big the company or depending on how big the website, you might find some kind of filtration. Here you can do, obviously, see, for example, if I click on marketing, it tried to filter out marketing personalities within this particular organization. And I can also do a search for to find someone specific or not. And you can see the results also shows with the name of the person, and it try to bring their job description if they have LinkedIn, and they do give out LinkedIn profile link as well, and shows us the location data, and you can see the actual email addresses. And if you click on this arrow mark, it will show where it was able to find this data, when it was seen, and is it still valid, all this data. For example, here it shows only one source, but if I open up this, you can see it says that it was able to get this email addresses from 6 different sources, and it mentions all the 6 different sources where it was able to find out. So we can see the actual source on where it was able to find the email also. And in case if there's a phone number available, we also do get that option as well. And we can save this as a lead. Lead is where this particular section where we can save some of the information we want to move forward or to reach out to them personally and keep a record of it. We can do that by just clicking on that, and you can see that a lead has been saved. We also have the option for the direct message, but it's not available within me. And we can see all the emails like that. You can see it's going up to 76 pages. Again, it's not going to be same for all the domain. Depending on the domain, it's going to the results also going to be changing. And if we want, we can also export all this into a CSV format as well. So basically, that is what the search functionality does. When we go to the finder, this is something different. We are, rather than just doing a domain search and trying to find all the person, we give some sort of name and a company detail and try to come up with the email address or potential email address. For example, I'm going to give my company my name in this field, and I'm going to say I want to find the person from this particular domain or this particular business site. When I click on search, now it will try to find this person if he has any valid email addresses within this. And you can see it automatically shows that it was able to find my email addresses. You can see this confidence score, like it shows how much confident it is on this particular email addresses. And I forgot to mention this in the previous search, where you can verify all this email addresses also. For example, when you click on this, it will automatically do a 4-step check on check the validity of the format, and type is checked, and server status is checked, and email status is also checked. And it also shows the more source information, everything. So we can also check the validity of here, and it will give me a company info. And when I click on view company mails, it will now show all the other people who are able to, was found within this particular company profile as well, and the email score. So depending on your need, you can do a domain search, or based on a personal name and the domain, you can go and search on that. Verify, as I mentioned, where you can pretty much verify any email addresses. You can also use email verifier within the search and finder, as I showed you. But in case if you are not sure whether an email address you have is good or not, this is a single verifier where bulk options are available within the bulk section. But in order to verify, all you need to do is just give some random, I'm going to give a wrong email addresses. So just to show whether how it works, when you click on search, now it will try to verify. For example, it shows invalid because this email address isn't used to receive email. You can see the format is valid, that is the first check, and type is also valid, the second check. But you can see it gives the invalid for server status and email status. If I hover over this, then now it shows how it will check the server status. So they verify the MX record, where we know that MX record handle email records for domain through DNS. And when we go into the professional checker, it shows what are the different types of validity status. For example, invalid means email addresses can't receive email. Blocked means that they have tried to implement a security measures to check whether to disable checking these kind of things. In that case, the only way to test it out by directly sending. Accept all is a catch all email addresses, so we can identify whatever the email address, even if there no email address does not exist, it is going to be going to this email address. If they have set up like that, we will see that option valid, as we know that in case if the everything is checked out, then it will show the valid. So we can see all the data for verify within this. Now when I go into the bulk section, basically bulk does the three of these different steps as I shown you, but it gives a bulk option to do in a much larger list of data. For example, if I have a list of website and I want to find email addresses for that particular list, I just need to click on this and you can see I have done different one. When I click on new bulk, I just need to give the name for the list and I give all the domain names which I want to check for this, and I want to select how many email addresses per domain do I want. Do I want only just 110 or something like that? I can choose go up to 100 email addresses. Verify email addresses, like once they found out the email addresses for this domain list, do I want to verify through that? And we can turn that option on or off, and we can also set the email address type, whether do we want all kind of email address or just a personal or generic. We can also set department, and also we can include the sources in case we want. You can also see the some of the limitation which is for this particular feature, including you can check up to 5000 domains in this section, you can find up to 50,000 email addresses per file, and some special on expected characters will be deleted. All these things are shown here. So with this tool you can check up to 5000 domains per check for list, and it can find up to 50,000 emails depending on your need. So the next bulk checker is going to be email finder, where it's similar to the finder option, where we can create a new bulk and try to find email addresses based on the names or whatever the details we provide and get the data from here. So that is the new bulk email finder. And email verify is the same concept, where rather than verifying one by one, if we let's say have a source of like thousands of email, I want to see what are the valid emails within this, possibly before a cold outreach campaign, you paste the list of address and you can see how many emails where you can verify up to 50 email addresses per domain name every 24 hours, just to making sure to have spam filters to make sure make sure there is no abuse on the system. And you can check up to 10,000 email addresses per bulk. So in case if you want, you can check up to 10,000 email addresses to make sure that is valid and it's ready to send. And web email address like Gmail, Outlook, disposable email addresses are skipped. So they do only check out professional email addresses. It's a limitation. So in case if you have a generic email addresses, that is not covered on this system. And also it shows some other instruction as well. So that is what the bulk section of the tool does. And the final section is leads, where as I shown you, whatever the data you saved, you can see it on the leads. For example, you get some sort of like a CRM aspect of it, where you can see you can create different lead lists depending on your need, and you can also connect to various different application for third-party application integration, and you can see all the leads, which I personally don't use this, that's why you don't see any of this data. But when you add a person to this particular location, we can click on this particular row and it will open up sort of like all the data they have for this particular person. If they show the name, if they have an email, they will show it, and LinkedIn link, first name, organization they are working for. We can add notes and serve it as a private, and we can also connect to various different platforms. So basically that's all what Tomba does. Basically it finds email addresses through different couple of different ways, helps you to verify and helps you to do it in a bulk fashion with the lead. They do also do a lot of development to the app, and they have been consistently improving it. You can see the development either by the notification here, you can see the some of the development are happening like 5 days ago, 5 days ago, all these things are shown here. And if you go into the roadmap, you can see already released section and what are the released on 2021 and what are they are currently working on in progress on all the different things they are currently working on next up, all these things. And if I scroll down here, we can see the future and idea request. So basically, it is affordable and a good deal to be for honest to be on an email finder kind of solution. But I wish they would improve their website to be much more trustable for users to understand the product much better. So I hope this video was useful. And if you have any other question, feel free to let me know and I will be happy to clear it out. Once again, thank you so much and have a great day. Cheers.